Hello, welcome everybody. This is Dr. Bolad. Today I will talk to you about the decision-making process to either use heart stents or bypass surgery in patients with blocked or narrowed coronary arteries. For those who are new to my channel, I am a board-certified cardiologist and interventional cardiologist. And here on this channel, you will find lots of education about heart health and heart disease. So if you are interested, don't forget to subscribe and switch on the notification bell so you don't miss any new videos that I post. So let's get started with this video about heart stents compared to bypass surgery. Patients with blockages in one or more of the coronary arteries need to be revascularized, which means that they need the blood supply restored to the part of the heart muscle affected by the blockage. This is done by one of two ways, either by placing a stent by a procedure known as percutaneous coronary intervention, referred to as PCI, or by bypassing the blockages by open heart surgery by a procedure known as coronary artery bypass surgery, referred to as CABBAGE. There are important differences between the two procedures, and these come into the decision-making process of which procedure to use. Stenting is a less invasive procedure than bypass surgery. The patient is awake during the procedure and sometimes sedated, and the patient is discharged home from hospital usually on the same day or the following day of stenting. The patient recovery period is short, and within a few days the patient is back to his or her normal self and can go back to work as usual. The patient will continue to take aspirin for life and another blood thinner generally for a few months. By contrast, bypass surgery is a major surgical procedure, requires general anesthesia, and requires opening the chest wall to reach the heart and bypassing the blockages by arteries or veins from other parts of the body. The patient stays in the hospital for a few days, and when discharged, requires a few weeks of rehabilitation to get back to the status before surgery, and needs a few weeks before he or she can go back to work. So, how do we choose which procedure to use for our patients? And why do we still refer patients for open heart bypass surgery rather than putting stents, which are less invasive? Our decision is based on many factors for best long-term outcomes based on data we have accumulated over the years from hundreds of thousands of patients who had undergone both procedures, and is also based on data obtained from research. Before we discuss this, let us first talk about who needs either of these revascularization procedures in the first place. Revascularization with either stenting or bypass surgery, as opposed to continuation of medical therapy, is needed for patients with activity-limiting symptoms despite maximal medical therapy. Active patients who need stenting for improved quality of life compared to medical therapy, such as those who are not tolerating medical therapy well, or who want to increase their activity level. Patients with anatomy for which revascularization has a proven survival benefit, such as significant left main coronary artery disease, who have greater than 50% narrowing, or multiple coronary artery disease with over 70% narrowing with a reduction of the left ventricular pumping function, and a large area of the heart muscle not receiving enough blood supply. Before choosing stenting or bypass, the patient should be informed about the procedural risks, including that of death, stroke, and the need for repeat revascularization. Stenting is generally performed on the following patients, although there will be exceptions. In patients with single artery disease, the recommendation is to perform stenting using drug-coated stents. In patients with two coronary artery disease involving the right and circumflex coronary arteries, good outcomes are achieved with stenting using drug-coated stents. In patients with narrowing of all three main coronary arteries, bypass surgery is generally better for long-term outcomes compared to stenting. However, in those individuals with simple blockages and who are not diabetic, stenting is also reasonable. In patients who refuse bypass surgery or for whom it is not an option based on other diseases or poor functional status, stenting may be reasonable to improve the quality of life irrespective of the disease complexity. In patients with high risk of death from bypass surgery, stenting is performed. Open heart bypass surgery is recommended for patients with two or three main coronary arterial disease in whom complete revascularization cannot be accomplished by stenting. Bypass surgery would be preferable. Patients with blockages in all three main coronary arteries, especially in diabetic patients. Patients with disease of the left anterior descending artery in addition to either the right or circumflex coronary arteries when the patient suffers from diabetes. Best long-term outcomes are achieved by bypass surgery, especially when a large amount of heart muscle is supplied by the diseased narrowed arteries. In patients with two or three main coronary arterial disease who have reduced heart function, bypass surgery would be preferable. In some patients, after considering the factors I mentioned, it is occasionally not clear whether stenting or bypass should be performed. In this case, we either recommend stenting or ask the patient whether he or she has a preference after discussing the risks and benefits of both procedures. If you have any question about what I presented to you today, then subscribe to my channel and share your question in the comment section below, and I will reply to you. If you have a question that you would not like to share in public, then follow me on Twitter or Instagram at Dr. Bolad, and then send me a private direct message, and I will reply to you. If you found value in this video, then please like and share this video with family and friends. This is Dr. Bolad helping you with your heart health. Thanks for watching, and talk to you soon.